All right, guys, we are back, and we're about to get started here with some one-pocket action. Justin Cohn and Cliff Joyner will be playing. Alright guys, it's going to be Cliff Joyner and Justin Cohn. This will be the final four of the one loss side, or of the tournament actually. It'll be Justin Cohn and Cliff Joyner. The winner of that will play Danny Smith. And the winner of that event will play, for all the cheese, Billy Young, who's waiting on the hot seat. We're waiting for Cliff to get back in the arena right now. Took a short, quick break after that 10-ball defeat to Herman Quarles. Thank you. All right, looks like Justin Cohn has won the flip, and he'll be leading us off. This is a race of three, one pocket. Guys, what's the first break? Justin Cohn out of the chute here. Cliff Joyner surveying the table. Doesn't really have a shot here that I can see. If you're just joining us, this is Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck, and we're here in Jackson, Mississippi at the Green Room. This is the Viking Q Olhausen Billiards Tour, the one-pocket division. Four players left right now. One of the four players left joining us in the booth right now, Danny Smith from Atlanta. Danny, how you doing, buddy?
Pretty good. What's going on, pool fans?
Man, this should be a good match right here. Justin's been playing really well for a while. And you know Justin, don't you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, me and Justin have played a lot before. But he came off a good break here. Cliff couldn't do much but just kick at that 11 ball.
Pretty risky shot. I mean, if I was shooting that, I'd been in the drink right there. Yeah. But Danny Smith waiting to play the winner of this match here. And Danny, what do you think?
I'm ready.
How do you like your chances?
I like them a lot. I'm playing good right now. I'm playing good one pocket.
I do too. I was really surprised, you know, that you didn't take Billy in the hot seat, but he got some good roles, you know, and played well as well.
Yeah, that.
He's playing pretty good.
I had that one cut shot that killed me, where I made it in scratch, where I could have ran out, gone up 2-1. I think Justin's just going to try to bank both these balls to his pocket here. Bank the 7 up table and the 4 towards his pocket.
So he's using a 7 ball to bank the 4 with.
Yeah, he should be, depending on what angle he has. Let's see.
There's hardly anybody to play one pocket with where I'm from.
Really?
And we're trying to get it going, you know. We're trying to get some people interested in it. And it's working, you know, a little bit, but still not that much one pocket action. And it's always good to have someone commentate with me that knows the game as well as yourself, you know. I mean, young gun, 22 years old, knows the game really well. Really impressed with your game.
It sucks, and you can't ever get better when you don't have people around you that don't, or, you know, they don't play a game. He just went ahead and tried to bank the 7 ball straight.
Wow.
It wasn't that bad of a shot because Cliff really doesn't have much to shoot at here. He can shoot the 6-4 combo probably because the 11 ball is tied up.
Take a look at the overhead.
Justin's got his game face on. He's serious.
Yeah, from the internet chat room, Danny, well, it moved so fast I forgot, but someone was asking, who do you like in this match?
Well, you got to like Cliff. He just knows so much, and he's been around for so long. Race to 3, it doesn't matter who's playing. Anybody can win, but if I had to pick somebody, it'd be Cliff.
That's true.
Justin knows the game really good, and he shoots really good, so, I mean, it's just a toss-up. These next 3 or 4 matches that are going to be played are just going to be toss-ups because it's a race to 3.
Yeah, there was a lot of talk about that at the T-Town Classic, you know, just making it that race to 4, that one extra game really kind of changed things considerable.
It's huge. Looks like Cliff's going to shoot the 284 here.
Nice shot. Cliff on the board with one.
He's going to shoot the eight, but he's going to try to get on two, but if he can get on this, oh. He wanted to get on the two and then get an angle. If he could have got on that 10, he could have broke the whole stack out. He's still going to bump this 14 here, but no, he went around.
Okay, maybe he's going to break it up off the six ball here.
Yeah, he can break it up a bunch of different ways.
Good shot. He got unfortunate to end up with only a combo here. But after that three-way combo a second ago, I don't think this is going to give him any trouble.
No, I think he's going to get out here.
Shot. Cliff with five now. Just like that.
He's all right. Shit the combo here again. His pockets are so big.
Very generous pockets on the Olhausen table here. They haven't had a chance to, or an opportunity to do anything with this table at all. It just showed up like 2 days before the event.
Right.
That's it. Cliff Joyner takes rack number one. And we'll be right back.
Viking, a cue for the shot.
Cliff Joyner breaking.
Not a very good break. Justin's got a bank here on the 10 or the 5. Most likely to shoot the 10.
See, that's one comment I would never be able to make, that it wasn't a very good break. So I just have no idea.
He's going to shoot the 5.
Nice shot, too.
Shoot the combo here and just lower all the cue ball in the stack.
Mr. Bobby in the house. Bobby B. Joining us on the internet chat room. Justin Cohn got a little opportunity here. Leading 2-0 right now on the ball count. Quiet in here all of a sudden, didn't it?
Yeah, it did.
So we have to put on the golf voice.
Good shot here. And kick safe.
You know, as a noob on one pocket, you know, you always hear everybody say, oh, you shouldn't kick at a ball.
Right.
You know, and
everyone always says that's the number one rule, don't kick at a ball.
Right, right. But I guess at Cliff's level, you can, or yours even, you know, planned kick, not a bad shot.
They just teach a lot of the newcomers don't kick.
Look at this shot.
But that's a good
thing. It was a great thing. I mean, it didn't fall, but it was a great shot.
Yeah, he didn't want that ball to fall. Because he's stuck up table up there, he really wouldn't have a shot.
So he's in much better shape that it's parked in the garage there.
Yeah.
Or should we say driveway? Not quite in there.
He's wanting to play three ball combo carom here, the 7, 14, 13 off the 6, but he wants to make the three ball at the same time.
Now, would this be considered a dead ball in the pack here? Oh, yeah. That's kind of a, I mean, it's
somewhat of a dead ball. I mean, you got to make it, but that's not a dead ball. You don't know if it's going to go or not.
Nonetheless, it's pretty gutsy firing at it, in my opinion. I mean, a lot of people would just knock the 3 in here.
If he knows he can make the 3, and the 13 might go or come close to his pocket, it's a good shot.
Cliff Joyner leading us 1-0. This is the one-pocket division. 4 players left in the one-pocket division here at the Viking Q Olhausen Billiards Tour stop here in Jackson, Mississippi at the Green Room. Well, Cliff went ahead and knocked that 3 ball, and I guess he couldn't get the confidence up on that.
Actually, what he tried to do there, instead of hitting the 7 first, he tried to make the 3 and then hit the 7.
No kidding.
And take a skew up there, well, yeah.
Man, I didn't even see that at all.
He just missed the whole 7 ball. It really wasn't a bad shot, though.
He got kind of fortunate to stick it in the pack like that.
Yeah, he got rolled around the table a little bit. Pretty good shot. 10-2 lined up dead. Justin's just going to bank the 12 into the 2, 10, 11 and try to get his cue ball. Most likely just up by the side pocket. He might try to take it up table. He might just come off the 6 here and just come underneath the 2, too.
I can't tell from where I'm sitting. Does 12 ball go in Cliff's pocket?
Yes. Yeah, he's just going to come off the 6 and try to get underneath this deuce. Get the 6 ball on his side of the table. He didn't mean to make it, but... Cliff's just going to... probably most likely just bank the 7 into this 10 deuce and run the cue ball into the 4.
Justin kind of reminds me of a player down in Texas. A lot of us on the internet chat room will know him, Deadwack.
Deadwack.
Old Bob Piles from San Antonio. They kind of resemble each other a little bit.
Another good shot here is banking the 7 into the 13-6 and drawing your cue ball back on the 12-11. Drawing them right behind the balls on the bottom rail right there. 13-6 might be dead. Definitely a better shot. Well, the That's not what he wanted to do, but it worked out.
Players in the one pocket division here at the Viking Q Old House and Billiards tour stop in Jackson, Mississippi at the Green Room. This is Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck, and joining us in the booth right now is Danny Smith out of Atlanta. I think we're going to be seeing a lot of good things out of this young man. If I can toot your horn a little.
If I keep going.
22 years old and already got quite a few accomplishments in the pool world. Also about to start. Wow, how was that?
Just made a good two-rail bank on the nine ball.
About to start school for accounting and also picked up a minor sponsorship from OBQs here recently. Good stuff.
Put a 6 off of 13 and bring his cue ball behind Cliff's balls. Oh, he made a great shot. Fired it.
Awesome shot. Gives him a 5-1 lead ball count this game. Fighting to tie things up here.
Once again, just like yesterday, if you're not 18 years of age or older,
I want to cover your ears for this song.
You need to go on MySpace or do something else for a little bit. Music here is
rated R.
Rated R. Justin did I think he's a wizard. He pointed his magic wand and the ball went straight in the hole.
Some serious follow through there.
Yeah. Did you see that follow through? Huh? Did you see it? Did you see it?
This combo here is going to be a lot more difficult. You think he's going for this?
Oh, yeah. He might. Cliff really doesn't have any balls that go in his pocket, so it's kind of a free shot. But he might just go ahead and play the keyboard down the table. Yeah, that's what he's doing. I don't like that shot because he just broke up Cliff's balls. And if Cliff can get a ball to go to his pocket, Justin's going to be in trouble now. Wow.
That's it. Cliff concedes that racket. Ties it up 1-1.
It's a big game for Justin because now Justin's got the break, so he's got a chance to take the lead here.
Absolutely.
Justin's ready to take this game off here. He's got a serious game face on. Definitely ready to play.
1-1, tied up.
Justin made a great break there.
Either for that Viking logo up over that Lukaski logo or something. If not, I got to pull that Lukaski down from that angle. I just realized that that was sitting there. Viking will be pissed. Yeah. But that works too. Okay.
I look at all.
Yeah, I forgot about it.
Justin made a great break here. He's got all the balls by his hole, and he's got Cliff locked up. Oh, he had a dead ball. That's what you call a dead ball right there.
And I looked away for just a second there. That was... 1. Now he's leading 2-0 in the ball count.
Yes. Looks like he's going to get out here. All the balls are laying pretty good for him.
And again, it seems that finding that dead ball in that pack is key. Really open things up for you. I was really extremely preoccupied, Danny, earlier when you played the hot seat match there with Billy Young. I was just bummed that I didn't get to see that, man. And you had mentioned, was it eight and out and seven out? Or how?
That's when I played Cliff.
Okay.
I think it lasted about, someone said 11 minutes, but... I won the flip. I won the lag, and he left me a shot, and I banked the ball and went 8 and out.
Sweet.
So it was Cliff's break, so he broke the balls, and he left a ball leaked out in front of my pocket, and I ran 8 and out. And then the next game, I broke, made one on the break, ran seven, and played safe. And Cliff banked the ball on me and ran all of them but two and left the ball sitting right in front of my pocket. So I just shut it in.
Cool. Yeah, man. So we had some tech issues during that match, and we didn't get any of it recorded or otherwise.
Well, sometimes it's a good thing. Things people don't see things.
Yeah.
Well, giving Cliff a chance here.
Not a match you want to be judged for.
No.
Not when you play your best match of your life, maybe. I don't know. I don't know if that was that. But
probably not.
All I know is it wasn't long. I was working on the computer, and it was over.
It was over, yep.
Chagrin says, "We want to learn, man."
It's tough to races are three or so short, and I can try to say as much as I can, but everyone, all these things is what I would do, and these guys haven't been shooting
right.
A lot of things that I've been saying. You know, everyone does their own thing in one pocket. That's what one pocket's all about, is being creative and doing the things that.
And,
you can come up with.
Right, and many times there's like different ways to approach situations.
Right.
So you might have.
There's always, you know, three or four ways to shoot balls or run out or break balls up or just in any situation. And everyone does things different. They do it their own way.
That's cool.
That's where everyone learns from. Everyone learns from everybody else.
A lot of times you hear players talk about, moving to a different area or a different town, and
right.
then their game improves and goes up considerably,
right.
and it's just from, you know, seeing different ideas and different ways of doing things.
Just all experience.
That's awesome.
Whenever I got a lot better, I'd go to big tournaments, and every chance I get, I would walk up to Alex Tagaline or Efren or anybody and just say, hey, let's play some 28 games of practice. And those guys will never turn you down. They'll always, you know, they're all trying to make money, but they'll always sit there and play with you. But it's good to play people like that for 20 a game or whatever you can afford to play for, just for the experience and the practice. See what they do and see how hard they try and the shots they make and everything.
Dan, you got a lot of insight and wisdom for a guy that's 22, I got to tell you.
A lot of dedication. Don't even practice or play anymore, really. If I still practice and played every day a lot, I can really get up there. But
yeah, I'd like to see you with a nice big sponsorship that's they could actually afford you to play on a regular basis.
I got some people in Atlanta. I'm trying to. Well, I'm going to school and working. I want to get a hold of somebody that wouldn't mind flying me to maybe, you know, a certain amount of tournaments a year and put me in and get me a hotel and stuff like that. So.
That'd be awesome.
It's just,
hey, it's real. It could happen.
It's real tough and poor right now because really there's not a big tour up right now. There's not a lot of money involved, so.
Well, one tour you definitely want to pay attention to and keep an eye on is the Seminole Tour. Those guys are really looking at expanding the tour considerably, and they treat the players really good.
Yep.
And you know you're going to get paid.
Well, just like the IPT, you know, that was going real good for a little bit, and then they had a little. You know, they had an IBT broke up, but something in pool is going to happen real soon to where there's going to be a real good sponsorship and good tournaments and all that kind of stuff where the pool players are going to get rewarded. Pool is definitely one of the toughest sports there is. Everyone can play football. Everyone can play basketball. Everyone can play a lot of sports. Pool you got somebody else running out on you. You got somebody else playing safe on you. You got to kick at balls. You got to jump balls. It's all hand-eye coordination. And we're not getting paid for it. We need to get paid for it. It's not an easy sport. And we all tried as hard as we can, you know, to get paid. And it's just, it's real tough. Person that supports that really good is Charles Hillbilly Bryant.
He does.
He can go on for hours about how why pool players should get played or get paid and why we deserve it.
I know a lot of folks have only I've only seen the game face of Charlie Bryant, and he's really very interesting to talk to.
Yeah,
and he's more than willing to share with anyone that would like to learn something.
I forget exactly what he says. He compares pool to golf, but he compares how much harder pool is than golf. And he goes into detail for a while about it. But if you sit there and listen to him about it, you'll agree with him, you know.
Just tuning in, this is Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck, and I'm joined in the booth right now by a young gun, Danny Smith, out of Atlanta, 22 years old. Are you in school or about to start school?
I start on the 17th.
Sweet. About to go to school in accounting. So any of you players out there going to be looking for a good accountant, Danny might be your man.
Yeah. Keep some clients coming. Blah, 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 blah. Amazing how some of these one-packer games can take 3 minutes, and one game could take an hour or two. Justin just left Cliff a bank here. I don't know if he's going to try to bank this pinball or not.
Just joining us, this is Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck. Danny Smith from Atlanta, Georgia, in the booth with me at 1-1 right now. Justin Cohn versus Cliff Joyner. Well, I had 4-1 Justin on the ball count there. It may still be 4-1. Like I missed one ball somewhere, or two. That looks like 4-1 it is.
Justin did scratch. Wow, what a shot. Played the 11 off the 4 and banked it. That's where that creativeness comes in right there. The stuff you see like that.
Sticking the cue ball right there? Is that what you're referring to? Or
no,
the bank?
The shot before he Karen banked it. Little stuff like that can turn the game around in seconds.
Wow. I didn't think that ball was going. Bank combo now?
Yeah. Oh, he missed it. Left Cliff. Cliff's going to run some balls here.
Justin Cohn leading 5-1 on the ball count on this rack.
That's one of the things Hillbilly was talking about, was how golfers don't have things blocking their view.
Right. Yeah, I seem to remember that conversation now.
They don't have balls blocking their view. They don't have people getting
right.
lucky on them and bouncing off trees and going in the cup.
Exactly. 5-4 now. Justin leading on this rack.
He's going to bank this 9 ball and try to take his cue ball across the table here to get on his 3. Looks like he hit the titty down there at the end of the table.
He got fortunate.
Got very. Come off another ball there. There comes Clifford.
Yeah, he still needs 2, though. It's going to be tough to get 2 here.
He might only need 1. We might have lost track. I think Cliff just said that's his out ball.
Okay, I must have missed something somewhere. We got 4 balls still on the table, and I had Justin at 5. So we give Cliff 6. I guess we'll find out here.
Justin's going to try to double kiss. He tried to double kiss the 14 to his hole.
That was very unfortunate. No, he did just need one. Wow. All right. Cliff Joyner.
Alignment, precision weighting, solid and thick.
All right, we're back. Very brief commercial there for Viking Cues. Sponsor for the Viking Q, Olhausen Billiards Tour here. Sure appreciate all of their support, making all of this possible. Big part of it.
Cliff came up with a good break here. Looks like Justin's going to try to stick the cue ball in the stack here. He's going to try to get this four ball to his side and stick the cue ball in the stack, maybe. He might stick his cue ball up table two behind the five. Well, I don't know what he did there.
A lot of body English, whatever it was.
Yeah.
They're going to be lining up to play Justin after this.
Yeah, I don't know what that was about there, because if he wins this game, he's got the break. He's got a huge advantage, so I don't know why he would try something like that. It's a real important game there. I'm going to have to put my cue together here in a second.
Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck, and I'm joined in the booth right now by Danny Smith out of Atlanta. Danny waiting to play the winner of this match. Looking forward to that one, too. Wasn't long ago that Danny was playing Cliff Joyner earlier here and finished the match, and might have been 11 minutes, but it was definitely under 17. Somebody said 17 minutes. That's here in the room. Pretty fast, though. Just boom. I looked down. I looked up. It was over.
Cliff's got five balls now, and this isn't looking too good for Justin. He shouldn't have taken that wild shot. Cliff's going to come with a two-rail bank right here. Doesn't want this ball leaking, the 11 ball leaking out. The deuce.
Yeah.
He's all right. A lot of the balls are angled towards Cliff's pocket, so Justin can't do much damage here. One thing about one pocket, here's good advice. No matter how many balls your opponent has, if your opponent needs one and you need eight, or you need nine, or you need seven, don't ever think that you have to take that crazy shot. Don't ever think that you have to go for that crazy bank.
Mm-hmm.
You play every as tight as you can play. One pocket, you got to play tight.
Nice shot right there.
I remember numerous times I needed 9 or 10 balls, and my opponent needs one, and he's on the hill, and I come back and win the set, or I come back and beat him.
Right.
This is real good for Justin. If he can pull through and win this game, he's got the break, so he'll definitely have an advantage in the last game. That's how quick the game can change around.
Big time. Really, I also think that, with the boom of streaming, I mean, they're streaming at all the major events now, and, it's more and more players are getting used to playing on, with the cameras rolling and the,
right,
and lights and, and people commentating, and it's really, making play a lot more players are more comfortable playing.
Well, I think
if you make it to a TV match,
I think the players try a lot harder. A lot. There's players that makes them nervous, and there's a lot of players that try harder and it makes them play better, but I always try to just cut out the crowd, cut out the cameras, just cut out everything in sight and just zone in. That's the best thing you can do.
Good advice.
You'll always play the same, and you're playing your game. You worry about everybody else at the end when you win.
Good stuff there, Danny. Well, I totally lost the ball count here. I don't know what it is. I know Justin...
Justin needs one.
Okay.
I think he gave Cliff an opportunity here to bank this 4 and make the 7. There's one kind of shot you don't want to leave Cliff at the bank. Looks like he made it.
Wow, nice shot. For the game. It's hill, folks.
Justin's got to come off of a strong break here to seal the deal against Cliff Joyner.
You're watching a one-loss side match here. We've already got a winner of the hot seat there. Billy Young won the hot seat by defeating Danny Smith in the hot seat. Danny waiting for the winner of this match here on the one-loss side here, and then we'll move right into the finals.
Justin hit those balls. He hit the second ball a little bit too thick there, and gave Cliff a shot. In one pocket, when you're breaking, you want your cue ball to end up at the diamond or the dot close to the side pocket, and you want it to stick to the rail. That way your opponent can't put any English on the ball, and they can't, they just can't do much with the ball at all. And you can do that by, when you use your inside English, you're supposed to use inside English on your break, but all tables take the ball different off the bottom rail when you break. So you can do that by using less English or going higher or lower on the cue ball. But if you want to practice your break, your cue ball should definitely be on the rail at the dot closest to the side pocket. you'll find out that it'll be a lot tougher for your opponent to get out of your break.
That's very, very interesting. Never really thought about, you know, high and low on a break.
Well, you figure, just like how Justin just broke, if Cliff didn't have a shot to make a ball in his pocket, he's still able to see all the balls by Justin's pocket. So you want the stack to be blocking your side of your pocket. Cliff just took a flyer.
This could be bad news, too.
This 100% is bad news.
Catch that 14 ball.
Yeah, he was a little careless there. He could have came a couple of different ways there coming off that ball, and he just kind of got up there and just whacked at it. Bad shot for being jacked up. He could have done a lot more damage.
Now here comes Cliff Joyner. Justin leading 3-0 right now.
I think Justin's going to go ahead and bank this 5-ball with low right English and hold his cue ball at the top right of the table up here. Yeah, he just didn't cut it enough.
Wynn from the internet chat room is asking if Randy Cole was down here. I haven't seen him. Of course, he could be rolling in any time. Another part of the Viking Q Olhausen tour stop is the 9-ball amateur. That's starting tomorrow.
Yeah, a lot of players aren't here yet because they're waiting for the 9-ball to start up. A lot of people are questioning and don't know why, but they said that the bar table tournament tomorrow, the 9-ball tournament, is played on the bar tables, but the finals are going to be played on the big table.
Yeah, semifinals and finals, and are going to be played here on the old house and as a tour sponsor. There's reason for that. Olhausen actually provided this table to the green room for adding the money to the event here. Nice arrangement.
I actually like going from the bar table and playing in the finals on a big table.
Right.
A lot of players don't like it because they're all bar table. I like it.
Yeah. Well, you know, playing on different kinds of tables and even on the 9-foots over here, you know, I mean, there's 3 different kinds of 9-foots. We got gold crowns, we got diamonds, we got Olhausen now. So, I mean, I really believe it adds depth to your game, you know, being able to make various adjustments, you know.
It's good to practice on every table you can get your hands on because every tournament you go to is going to be different. Every table is going to be different. You need to be able to adjust within minutes to that table, you know?
Exactly.
Not 100% sure yet, but there's supposed to be a matchup tonight. I'm supposed to give Clifford Joyner the last 2 playing 10-ball on the big table, so.
No way.
We'll see what happens.
That'd be cool.
See what Cliff can do. Justin got all the balls on his side of the table here. It's gonna be a long game here.
Yeah, from the internet chat room, they're asking if we'll be streaming that action match. There's a good possibility. We definitely we've got the roving cam now that we can flip over to any table in the room here. So we've got the feature table here, the old house, of course, but also got the cam loaded up and ready to zoom in on anything in the room. It worked pretty good too. We did a few earlier. Recently added the old house in here, and also the diamond that you see in the background. They're both new additions to the green room here. Great room. If you haven't been here, Big Truck always stops at the green room when I come through Jackson. Been coming here for years. Always came on the down low, though. Can't hardly do that anymore. Guess I ought to stop putting my picture in the intro to every single match. Maybe I could go on the down low still. On the table is also a brushed aluminum. Pretty cool. All the words are.
He's trying to protect his side. He's got all the balls on his side of the table. Cliff's in a bad spot here. It's going to take him a while to get all his balls out of the way. Well, he made a great shot there. You know what the race is tomorrow for the Saturday nine ball tournament?
Race to 11.
That's awesome. That's awesome. people get too lucky or bad things happen in those short races.
Well, I had Justin down as three, but I just saw Cliff drop what sounded like three balls in the side pocket. I swore I heard three plops when he dropped those. You got four balls down, too, total.
So you're thinking it's 2-2?
Might be 2-2. All right, Justin's going to take a quick restroom break. While he's doing that, a little word from our sponsors.
Perfect alignment. Precision weighting. Solid and stable. Perfect play from a perfect cue. Show them balls a good time. Viking Q, your best shot.
We're back. I noticed someone had just typed no ads here right when I ran the Viking ad. Can't cook that one off. Sorry, guys. No, that's awesome. We're rolling. Justin Cohn is taking a short break here. It says Hill. Final game. We've got four balls down. Don't know who's got what. I think it's 2-2.
Last call for the kitchen, everybody. Last call for the kitchen.
All right, we just got confirmation. Young Gun Danny Smith went up and checked the holes, two apiece.
Taking a short break too. I don't know if a lot of people know, but a lot of good players showed up here for tonight's tournament, for tomorrow's tournament. Some of the names: Jonathan Hennessy.
Oh, no kidding. Hennessy's here. Huh?
Shane Winters.
Cool.
Real good player that hasn't been playing much. Justin Bergman.
No kidding.
Junior national champion, I think, 2 years in a row.
Crazy.
Action
update, folks.
There's definitely a bunch of players here tonight, and I know there's a ton more coming tomorrow. So
yeah, of course, already been here. Little D, Nick Vita, Jason Evans. I like Jason's game, man.
Yeah, he's improved a lot lately when I've seen him play, or a while back when I've seen him play. His game wasn't as strong as it was now. He's playing. He's stepped his game up quite a bit. Terry from Florida, Josh Hilliard. Little D from Hattiesburg. Nick Vita from Memphis.
You know what's cool about Jackson here? Man, everything's pretty close.
Yeah.
It's crazy. It's like so centrally located.
That's why I moved down to Atlanta from Ohio, because I used to have to come to tournaments in Georgia and Mississippi and the Carolinas. I used to have to drive so far. Well, now that I live in Atlanta, it's central. I don't have to drive very far.
Right. Juice joining us in the chat room there. How's it going tonight, Juice? Good seeing you out, man. Juice is asking, Juice from the internet chat room there is asking if there's any action going on since you've been here, Danny.
Yeah, there was a little bit earlier.
$40 ring game.
Yeah, we had a $40 ring game going with four players in it. So every time you won a game, it was $120. So it was a good ring game. Some other action that was going on. Daryl Biggert was playing a guy named Will, a younger guy named William from Mobile. They were playing 200 a game, one pocket. And Will ended up being up three games ahead. And they had to stop because the 10-ball tournament started, but they're going to play a little bit later tonight. And I think that's about the only action that that started up yet.
I got a feeling I'm going to be here for a while tonight.
Yeah, there's a...
Because we got the panning cam now. We can pan in on any table in the room here.
That's right. Kind of like a mini derby. Cameras in all parts of the room.
Yep, exactly. Only the room is the action room.
That's right. Justin's still keeping pressure on Cliff. He's got to get the 4 and the 11 broken up so he can have a few balls to shoot at. The only thing bad about how these balls are laying for Justin is they're blocking his bank path. So Cliff's really not in that bad of a spot here. Cliff can do a lot of moving around because Justin can't get a ball to the hole because they're all tied up.
Shot there by Cliff. Cue ball control seems to be really important in one pocket over some other games.
Very important. And one pocket, a lot of people think, a lot of amateurs or a lot of players that are beginning the game think they always have to make a ball. Well, one pocket's kind of like a chess game. You got to set yourself up to make your move. You don't always have to shoot a ball to your hole. You can get four or five balls by your hole and keep locking the guy up, and then when you get a chance you can run four or five balls at a time instead of running that one. There's a lot of times, to all the one pocket players, there's a lot of times when you have a ball in your hole sitting in the jaws of your pocket. Well, you don't have to shoot that ball. A lot of times you can maybe get another ball down by your pocket and lock it up, lock the cue ball up behind some other balls.
Right. Well, what you were talking about, how all these balls are blocking Justin's bank, but they're also blocking Cliff's bank, too.
They're blocking Cliff's short rail banks.
From the internet chat room, there are balls to the wall. Says we need to see a birth certificate. You know way too much for 22. Hey, it's a lot of it's the company you keep. You know, like
yeah.
You were saying, hey, hook up with some top players and learn some stuff.
Well, the truth is,
play them some cheap though. Don't try to get in there and get some free lessons.
10 a game. All those good players, if they're sitting around hitting balls, they love to play 10, 20 a game. For one, you know, they know they're going to make a little money, but for two, they love helping people.
Yeah, exactly.
I grew up, when I first started playing one pocket, I was about 13 years old. I never played the game before in my life, but the old guys in my town always played five a game. And for the first 2 weeks, I was losing, you know, five a game, but I was learning.
Right.
And within 2 weeks, I was spotting everybody in my pool hall. But I grew up playing a lot of one pocket. That's why I have so much knowledge at it. And I love the game, too, so that's a huge factor.
It sounds like you had quite a few old-timers showing you a little rope there, too.
Oh, yeah. Justin Bergman.
Justin Bergman about to play some 10-ball. With Mobile Will, or would that be Mobile Will?
Mobile Will.
Got to put that little twang on it. Mobile, Will.
Mobile. Get that southern accent going. Justin's got a good, he's in a good spot now. He's got balls by his pocket, and he's got Cliff in a little trap here. Cliff's going to have to do something creative here in a little bit. One of the things we haven't seen Cliff do much, he hasn't really had an opportunity to do, but Cliff takes a lot of fouls. He'll take the cue ball and send it somewhere on the table without hitting the ball and take a foul on purpose. And a lot of times, it's a really good shot. It'll win you the game.
Wow, did that tickle it before or after it hit the rail?
He got it on the way in before. Good shot. Looks like he's just going to try to tap this three and get the cue ball on the rail, but it was a real good shot by Cliff. He's going to play the three off the one. And the one went to his hole, too. Great shot.
Very nice. I'll tell you what, the advantage of this leaning towards Cone here by the shot.
More good advice, what Cliff just did, he went ahead and just made Justin's ball for him. A lot of one-pocket players, when there's a ball sitting in your opponent's pocket, you think you have to shoot at something. And then the next thing you know, you miss and you sell out the whole game when you can just make your opponent's ball and just battle it from there.
Sitting at, it looks like he's married right up on that 10 ball, but if you look at the overhead, he's got 2 or 3 inches from it.
Yeah, he's got a lot of room to work with. I think what he wants to do here is play the 10 ball past the side pocket. What I would do is bank the 10 ball to my side past that pocket and just draw your cue ball to that end rail and let it sit there. What Justin wants to do is just kind of spin the 10 towards his pocket and leave the cue ball on the end rail, but I like banking the 10 towards my pocket here and just get your cue ball back on that end rail. Yeah, that's what I would have done right there. It's a good shot.
He's going to have the whole stack over by his pocket here in a minute.
It's like chess. He's working his way up to make a move. Wait for your opponent to make a mistake.
Cliff is no stranger to this situation, though. He takes
a
foul.
What I tell a lot of my friends when I try teaching them or helping them, one pocket's a game of nit pull. You be as nitty as you can. Don't let your opponent make the mistake. Don't go for nothing unless you really think you're going to make it. Justin can put Cliff in a bad spot here. He can miss one and run into the stack. Cue ball got away from him a little bit there.
Atlanta Chris is giving you a shout out there. Danny from the internet chat room.
That would be my steak horse from Atlanta. What's up, Chris? Anything going on there, buddy?
If anybody would like a copy of all the T-Town Classic One Pocket matches that we've got available, and there's some awesome matches in there too, I got to tell you. Shoot a PM to Upstate Al or Shark in there, and we'll hook you up with that list. We can email it right out to you. Don't send it to don't send the request to me though, because I got stuff coming at me in every direction, and it gets lost a lot of times. Atlanta Chris says that Mitchell got beat by a dude from Florida.
I don't know how many times I said they can't, Mitch can't beat that guy, or just wait. I know he lost the other night. Are you saying they played again?
Let's ask him.
Did Mitch play the guy from Florida again?
Atlanta Chris. Games where you can really learn a lot of strategy. It's not just, you know, the pack opens wide open and the guy runs out, you know, I mean, it's
a lot of one pocket helps all your other games though too. One pocket will help you with your safety game. Let's say you're playing 9-ball or 10-ball, real touchy shots, little spin shots to help you play safe. One pocket helps you with, helps slow banking. Helps you bank balls better. It'll improve your rotation game a lot playing one pocket. One pocket also helps you move better in little areas. Let's say you got 4 or 5 balls tied up when you're playing 9-ball. Helps you break up balls better and just move in little areas better, too. It helps your game out a lot. People don't realize it, but it does. Cliff's got a bank on this 1-ball here. He can take over here if he can make this one.
Friend Juice there from the chat room is asking the payouts here for the One Pocket event here. I've got those in my hand here. The players auction payouts were an estimate, but the tournament pays, this is 21 players, $800 for first, $500 for second, $300 for third, $240 for fourth, $150 for fifth, sixth, $600 on the players auction first, as the approximates on the players auction, $300 for second, $150 for third.
First place, a total of $1,400.
Well, it's been an interesting game here. It's heading down table. Wow, that was interesting. I could have swore Cliff just bumped that 10 ball with his hand. Not that it makes any difference. But ball count is Cliff 3 and Justin 2 right now.
Cliff's going to go ahead and try to bank this ball. He's going to spin it with a lot of right hand English. He hit it good, but I don't know if he hit it hard enough. Great shot.
Ray Hansen, also known as Big Truck, and I'm joined in the booth right now by a young gun from Atlanta, Georgia, Danny Smith. Danny waiting to play the winner of this match here. Getting a little insight, and that's not like you don't really know how these guys play, but how are they playing today?
It's a bad shot by Justin there. He should have just went ahead and shot Cliff Ballin. That's what I was talking about earlier. Instead of shooting and selling out four or five balls, you just make Cliff's ball, and
yeah,
you don't sell out all them balls. Just take that one ball loss. Cliff's got a good angle here to get up table and run some more balls, so let's see what he can do.
Someone from the internet chat room there was asking if we knew how Justin Bergman was doing on the next table here against Mobile Will.
Justin's winning 3-0 right now. Or, I'm sorry, 2-0.
And he's breaking. Is it win or break on the...
It's alternate break, race to 5, single elimination.
Cool.
It's kind of a brutal format. Wow, Cliff getting a great shot right there. Cliff's got the ball count right now. Cliff's got 5 balls. Justin has 2. And Cliff just locked Justin up a little bit. Justin's going to, looks like he's going to have to go ahead and shoot this ball or try to play safety here.
Did he get there?
No. Looks like Cliff's going to close this out right here. He only needs 3 balls, and
he's got him.
He's got him right there, so. See if I can get up there and put some firepower on him a little bit.
Well, looking forward to it, Danny.
Just hope for the best. Wish me luck. We'll see what happens. I want to win this tournament.
There it is. All right, it's all over. Hey, good luck to you. Thanks for sitting in on the booth here.
That's right, man. I enjoyed it.
Very interesting commentary from Young Gun, Danny Smith. About to be up here next on the stream table. Cliff may need more than this one. He's seems like he'd be conceding if that was his last ball.
Oh, yeah. Looks like he needed two. He's gonna have to on two or less ball. Maybe he'll end it right here.
Man,
a little short.
I wouldn't even have come within a foot of that pocket.
Just from playing for so long, you just get
right.
Natural.
So how many beers does that make there?
My first Bud Light. You can calm me down a little bit for this next match and try to snap this tournament off.
Cool. Yeah, it'll be a good match. All the matches are going to be good from here on out.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, your match, and then we'll be heading right into the finals from there. Billy Young waiting, won the hot seat against Danny Smith here. Danny looking for some payback.
Sure am. Good shot there by Cliff. Kick bank.
Good. I think he got it, too.
Ooh.
Wow. Well, it's like you were saying earlier. I mean, even if your opponent just needs one ball, you still got a chance.
Yeah.
Not over.
You never give up. You don't know what's going to happen. Your opponent might miscue. Your opponent might scratch. You know, the game could turn around so quick. You never want to give up. A lot of times, too, when your opponent needs one and you need, let's say, five, six, seven balls, well, your opponent's trying to get that one ball hard, and you go ahead and make three or four, now your opponent's nervous thinking that you're going to come back and beat him.
Mobile Will gets on the board against Bergman. Bergman rattled the 10 ball. Gave it up.
Cliff might go ahead and try to bank this ball, but he only needs one, so it's kind of a risky shot.
Yeah, it's tough to do off the rail like that, too. That's really...
A little bit of left English, just go as high as you can. I think he's going to go ahead and try to bank this ball. And he made it. Great shot.
Wow.
Great shot by Cliff Joyner.
Well, good luck, young gun there. You got your work cut out for you.
Thanks a lot. Nice talking to you guys, and wish me luck.
Good luck, Danny.
I'll be back soon.